for a minute more just to start. Okay, hi guys, good evening. My name is Devanshu and here's Vid. We're going to be speaking about how we use content marketing to grow our traffic 100% in 8 months. You can call me Dev, but I'm not the Dev, he's the Dev, I'm Biz. Okay. We got the same response in Nashville, so we weren't expecting 2 months. Okay. So what is content marketing? I'm sure Felix covered it to an extent. How you distribute relevant content for your audience is how we term it as, okay, content marketing. So we approached content marketing with a couple of strategies in mind. We researched what are the industry-specific topics that are trending right now, especially related to Drupal. And then using that, we're attracting relevant content. Rinse and repeat the first two things, and then you convert your prospective clients into sales for that. But it wasn't that simple. We faced a couple of hiccups in terms of trying to generate technical content, especially from a marketer as me. So Vid's going to share in terms of what are the problems that we face while you're trying to generate technical content.
So, hi. How many of you have tried doing content marketing at your agencies? I guess, yeah, all of us try that. So I think the common problems that we faced as well, and I'm sure most of us are facing, is getting the technical team or the developers to expect them to write content, right? It's probably 1 out of 10 developers will be willing to do that, and finding that time from them is again another problem. So the biggest problem was getting technical content or semi-technical content generated from the technical team. Now, while we do that, why it is very important? Because today on content marketing, content is the king. We are deal with content management systems, but as a marketing from Google, from Google ranking perspective or organic traffic, there's nothing better than free traffic, right? And free targeted traffic. So our goal before we started this journey in this this process was to start getting free targeted eyeballs from organic search, and that from there on, and that too just following trying to explore the technical skill sets that we had in house. So that was the goal of this process, which we are going to talk about next.
Okay, so and then we shifted in terms of after understanding what are the basics for content marketing. Okay, then we more specifically went for Drupal as to where we want to generate our target audience from. Okay, so we made a plan called the Triple PRT plan. Okay, and the screenshots that you see here on are actual screenshots of our emails, of our stats, all of that. Okay, so what we did was we created focus areas. Okay, so development, Drupal, digital strategies. The list that you see are actual in terms of topics that are vetted by our technical team, by the business team, if they're able to generate that content. So that kind of research, we call it the bucket list of topics that needs to be generated over the next 3 months. We did a foresight for the next 3 months and created those topics and started generating content around that. Pertinent. So basically what we did was after these topics were selected, we started with the basic process where we create the structure. Okay, so the content and the technical team sit together, do that enough research, okay, and get that structure vetted by the tech team. So we have a very strong feedback loop with the technical team. Okay, so once they give in enough feedbacks, this is how feedbacks are given. So we use Google Docs, we don't use fancy SaaS softwares, but yeah, Google Docs work for us. So those are actual in terms of comments that are given by teams, and that's how we are generating our content. So the only aspect that we're doing, the brief that was given to our content team was, if the content piece that you're not writing is not the best piece out there, okay, is not in terms of do not write that. Because people, if they want to talk about your content, if they want to share it, okay, it has to be that. We're focusing on quality over quantity at any point, okay? So that's absolutely clear with the brief that's given out to the teams up there.
Before we move, so now this is the structure. So as I said, we have a very simple process. So as I said, the developers do not have the enough time or do not have the willingness to write full-fledged articles and content. So that's where we made it in a two-step process. Okay, we asked our dev team that, how much time do you think? We tried that, tried asking them to write full articles. They need 8 hours, 7 hours to write a full good article which they are happy about, and we don't have that time. Then we ask, okay, how much time do you really need to just put in your research and put in your skill in a raw way in a document? They said 1 hour. Okay, so if I worked on, say, Apache Solr implementation, I can really put in some 3-4 useful links and put in my notes, give references. So this structure preparation is what the developers are willing to do. It doesn't take them, bring them their writing skills in, right? So that's the first part where this the structure is done by the dev team. And this structure is taken over by the content marketing team. And they use this information and research while going through this nice feedback loop. And then they generate the final content. And it is easy for the developers to really read the final version and say, no, I think I like it. This is what I wanted to convey. So that's the feedback loop we are talking about.
Yep. That's all feedback that's given out. And progress, of course. Okay, so this is an actual screenshot of how we are measuring on a weekly basis, what was the goal that was set out and what was achieved and all of that. Okay, so it's very important to keep in terms of check, of course, for that as well. Week 39, we did 2 articles. Week 36, okay, so some information redacted, of course. Okay, so realistic, okay, so this was the feedback loop that was actually there. Okay, so there's a monthly topic bucket that we generate, gets reviewed by the tech team, a well-resourced structure is there, there's a multiple feedback loops, and we hit publish, okay? We'll make the presentation available for everyone on the website as well, so you can just ask questions if you want, yeah. But you can click pictures as well, that's fine. Okay, so time your goals, of course. So this is an actual content production calendar that we have. So if you see up there, so second of the month, there's a report that needs to be submitted in terms of what was done the previous month, okay? So if you see body structure and then content, so we divide a general article into 3 phases, okay, where the structure is done and the content is done and the final body gets published as well, okay. We see in terms of how many hours are we investing on a weekly basis as well in the month. This is what happened. So this is what happened. This is SEMrush screenshot. Okay, and that's how we, in terms of grew our content. So we invested a lot of time initially. Okay, so to make sure that we are creating that valuable content for people out there who can find us through Google searches or any other search engines for that matter. Right? Yeah. That's fine. So what we didn't do, I mean, of course, that's what we did, okay? So none of this stuff, okay? So no quick hacks, no keyword stuffing, black hat, gray hat techniques. There was never, what we have seen with content teams, essentially they're given a brief of put these 5 keywords in, repeat that. No, none of that. So there was a topic that was discussed, and because Google's algorithm is so advanced, okay, using LSI, latent semantic indexing, even if you end up using synonyms or words that stand for the same thing, your article will rank if it's providing valuable content out there. Okay, so don't have to worry about keywords at all from that aspect, okay? Nothing in terms of quick backlinking, none of that. No, I've seen people using press releases as a quick way to generate backlinks and create their credibility. If your article is the best out there, people will automatically link to you. Okay, people will automatically distribute it. You don't have to worry about that. No black hat or gray hat techniques. What we did do was all of this. Okay, so minimal quality content. We focused on grabbing new eyeballs. So something we experimented as well was inbound blogs and guest blogs. Okay, so a lot of authors out there, especially technical ones, they do not have a platform to write on. Okay, so we invited them. It's like you can always use our website to put your content in. Of course, there's a complete vetting process that we follow in terms of if there's unique content, of course, in terms of giving enough value to our user as well. Outbound is something we're still in the process of doing, but we are there. So we, in terms of reach out to technical publications, to be able to put out content out there. So we're creating a new platform, per se, to put content out there and get relevant traffic as well. So by learning something every day, so with the experimentations and lessons, something that we focused on was that we are listening versus listen to us. So we generate content for the people versus whatever we feel like. Okay, so we research in terms of what are the trending topics and what are people searching for, what is the potential in terms of new technologies that are coming into place, and generated content around that. If I'm going too fast, let me know. Okay, so So this is another screenshot from Google Analytics. If you can see, so new visitors, 81.7%. I mean, the more content they were producing, people get in terms of attracted to via Google and other search engines as well. So this is 8 months, and that's how we grew traffic. Those are actual numbers that we have. What worked the best? Okay, so being tactical plus personal in terms of our content out there, and also being a constant at industry events. So we started off with Drupal 2018, Badcamp 2018, we were there. So a couple of camps in India, okay, Midcamp Chicago, we were there. Badcamp 2019, we were there, and now we're here. Okay, so you have to grab new eyeballs, you have to make sure you're heard, your branding needs to be consistent with what you're producing, and you have to be in terms of available in the community to do that. So how business synced with content? This is where Vid will come in.
So now this was the part where we figured out a process where we're able to generate content and good quality content. Now let's come to the important part. How do we generate business? Now we have been generating content. How do we generate business? So we identified different focus areas. So for this example, we identified three focus areas. We have done some systems on, some solutions on LMSs, Drupal decoupled, Drupal federated search. So we wanted to sell this, essentially. We had already put up the right process of, this review and rinse and repeat process to generate the content. So the most important part is to identify your focus area and then really go deep into working with the content team and the business team, essentially figure out what kind of, create a bucket list of topics for, say, the next quarter or the next 2 months against your focus areas. And it's not about just writing one article or creating one page about one focus area. You really need to create multiple blog and articles about one focus area, so that someone coming on your site really goes through and builds the kind of trust that is needed. They're not just created a landing page to convert. There's really information on the site about this focus area. So you, the business team works with the content team to finalize this bucket list of the article in the focus area. And this is what has resulted. We followed the same process we discussed right now. And on pretty important focus area keywords, we coupled Drupal and Drupal as LMS or even Drupal LMS, we rank on the first page. So there's nothing new or anything specific done. No effort from SEO perspective. If we talk about SEO, a lot of things come in, and SEO is in a science itself. But we did nothing apart from writing vetted and quality content and going through this process. And this is the results, actual results from there. And then about the measurements, this is from analytics. And our focus area was, as I said in the beginning, was to grab new eyeballs, build the trust around our focus areas, and then convert them. So as you can see, majority of our traffic comes from Google, free organic traffic from the focus area, which is very useful, which has turned out to be useful. And as Devanshu said, if your content is good, people will distribute it. And we have been getting a decent amount of traffic from newsletters, a weekly drop, and other feeds who are actually consuming our content as well.
This is the official Drupal newsletter that gets rolled out every week. You guys must be aware of that. So again, so when you're out there now generating that content, okay, so these are the questions essentially that we kept asking before we hit the publish button. Does it have more to offer than what your competition is offering? Do you think it'll get referenced in an external publication? Would you be trusting this content yourself? Okay, how, of course, mobile friendly, okay, so that's a no-brainer as well. What is the substantial value that it provides in the search results is also very important. For example, decoupled Drupal, if there are 9 other results out there on Google, okay, what is the value those 9 are providing, and what's the value you guys are providing when you're generating content out there? So this is what we did. I think we're just in time for 5-6 minutes. So give value, and then ask for business. Okay. So we're not asking for businesses yet. We're still giving value. This is what we like to believe. Okay. And our prospective customers find us through the content itself that we generate. So I think we can be open to questions. Yes, please.
So probably, I think you zip past the traffic parameter, and sometimes it's important to sort of take 8 months, is too long a period. So it's important for my team to stay the course if you're doing something.
Oh, absolutely.
Have feedback if you're doing it right. So how do the growth breakup, first 4 months versus the next 4 months, because you need to keep getting that feedback that you're on the course and, you know, you're doing the right thing.
Absolutely. So so when we were tracking it via Google Analytics, via SEMrush as well, of course, okay, so you don't see any progress for the first 2 months, 3 months, and that's the, in terms of the incubation period that will be there, irrespective of however you are. If you stay true to the course in terms of generating quality content out there, so you will see nicks here and there. For example, the references in quality publications might already start coming in. You don't have to wait for Google search results to give you that sort of traffic spurt as well. So yes, it's very important. And only if you see 8 months here, there's at least 6 months of no activity before this. Okay, yeah. So
the tipping point happens for 6 months.
3 months, I would say. Yeah, 3 months.
So that has to be there.
So 3 months, you have to be really patient, and keep on doing what you're doing, and you will start seeing results in 3 months.
Yes, please.
Sure. I can see there's a clear correlation between creating your content growth, I presume, in visitors and in terms of reading content. Is there a direct correlation between people reading the content, increased growth in people actually engaging with the content, and an actual business coming through? I don't see that anywhere.
I didn't hear the question completely, but I think I got your question. So it was about, I think you asked, if the traffic is growing, is that converting into business? Is that correlation?
Yes, and also, this is a great stat, 1,100%.
Yeah.
Percentages for actually increasing.
Oh yeah, okay. So what happened with us now, since we did this the first 3 months, we were not really doing the focus area. We were just generating content and random topics which we found relevant. The moment we started focusing on focus areas, we grouped our topics. We'll not write about anything else. These are the three areas we want to write about. And after that, we started getting leads which really converted from that.
Yeah. The reason also we didn't do that initially is because you need to build credibility as a content influencer in the market. Okay, so if we started right off with focus areas at the start, it would become then become too salesy. So you have to first give, I think, value back, and then probably,
One further question. Looking at some of the content which you have published, it's quite tech-heavy, quite tech-focused.
Yeah.
I wonder who your audience is there.
Yes. So our focus area, our audience, we are an agency back in New Delhi. We work with other agencies to help them extend their team. You know, so that's why you see a little bit more of tech content. But if you explore our site, you'll see pretty much a decent ratio between business content and technical content.
Yeah, so personas were kept in mind who our potential customer is going to be. Yeah. Yes, you have.
I just wanted to know how big your company is, how many people are working with you.
Yeah, so we are...
Content team and the developers.
Okay. So there are two full-time content developers, and we are a 54 people company, but there are two full-time content people, and probably six to eight people from the tech team support them in doing the research. Yeah.
Yes, please.
Yes. Is your call to action just basically get in touch with us?
Yeah.
That's the next part we are starting to focus on. So first area was to really grow the organic traffic, start getting the first eyeballs. We were not really heavy. We have not really invested too much time, and are into focusing on increasing the conversion rate. So that's the next step. Now since we have the traffic, that'll be the obvious next step to optimize from the conversion perspective.
Okay, you haven't done that.
No.
The only CTA right now is yes. Drop a line to us. Yeah.
Just curious. Any rich content you had? Videos or largely text?
It was largely text. But we are investing in SlideShare and getting that same content converted to slides as well, so that people can easily digest that. Again, you convert those slides to coupled with a audiobook as well, so that becomes a video. So we're exploring all of that. But right now, we absolutely focus on long form content. Yeah. Yes, please.
How long typically has it taken for someone to sort of read a piece of content that you've put out to then becoming a customer? Like, how long is that journey?
I mean, I would love to find that answer for myself, but yeah. So, again, the idea right now is in terms of we're not looking at immediately conversion. We're not looking at that. Okay. So for example, learning management systems is something we've generated a lot of content around that. Okay. So we want people to explore that as a self opportunity and then get in touch with us. Okay. The short answer is I don't know that, but yes, we would love to in terms of after we put those conversion techniques in there. Okay. Let's see in terms of. But again, in terms of initial surveys with our potential customers who get in touch with us. I mean, I think it's taken about a week to get in touch with us. The sales cycle in Drupal is slightly longer, okay? So that takes about a couple of months, 3 months to get that final sort of conversion, right?
So one mistake now, but what I've seen a lot of people doing, you know, in terms of content marketing from day one, okay, we are trying to build an amazing website. Yes, that's very important. But your good website is only as good as the kind of traffic you're getting. How many people are actually getting to experience your website? That is one part. So parallelly, even if you're trying to revamp your website from, you know, business lead generation perspective, I would say start doing content marketing day zero. You know, so that you build up while you are, you know, launching your, you know, fresh website, and then when you have a decent amount of traffic, then think about conversion, because if only 100 people are getting to your website, how many are you converting? That the first thing is to bring volume of traffic.
Yes, please.
So about the value, then ask. How are you doing the ask part? Are you actually trying to get subscribers for a newsletter? Are you actively trying to go after them to ask for something?
Oh, so yeah, good question. So we are right now in terms of, we haven't started out an official newsletter for our own website. Okay. So but right now we're grabbing those email IDs and then we'll be. So like I said, towards the last part, we haven't really gone out there. So we focused on content as inbound marketing technique only as of now. Okay. Yeah.
Do you have a statistic of your bounce rate?
Yes. Yeah.
I think it was 60%, yeah. Which is high. So that is something.
Is it increasing or decreasing?
It has been constant, and that's the thing. What happens with organic traffic? So if you split your traffic coming from, say, Drupal newsletters or organic bounce rate will always be high. So we had something around 66, but I think that can be a little bit controlled once we are working on our new website. So things might change, but that's a known point, definitely. And you will face it. If you're doing, getting organic traffic, you will have issues with bounce rate, but then you don't need, who are the people who bounce off? People who are landed on your website, but on your page or your content, but it's not really relevant for them, because Google might be ranking us for, say, decoupled Drupal, but it might also be ranking us for a lot of other keywords in that article. So we are not relevant to them. So we are not really bothered about too much about the bounce rate, as long as the targeted people are staying.
I think we're just in time to wrap up. Oh yeah, please.
You said that you have a target group to make content for other agencies to work with it. But what do you think, or did you try to get direct businesses, actually, end clients with this content marketing technique?
Yeah, we did. One of the focus, we did actually. So there are a lot of different kind of clients who have some kind of tech team in-house as well, even though they're not agencies. So those kind of customers as well, yes.
So that focus area was StarFog, is what I'm saying. Yeah, basically. So I think we're good. Thank you, guys. Thank you for coming in. You can always rate our sessions. Okay. Yeah.